to Jimps Gaming Channel. Today we're going to be doing a review on the new costume heroes of Atlantis. And right now we're going to start with Costume Ariel. So if you're not familiar with Costume Ariel, she is the enchantress of the Atlantis, or enchanter of Atlantis. Right now her costume, we're going to take a look at this a little further, but I want to tell you, I actually had a chance to talk to some more people live and they get a little feedback from her. So let's see what they said. As far as we talked about heroes, is somebody you would want to get? And we have, let's take a look here. She was just released today. So yeah, today this was just released. And we have Paul saying that she would be a welcomed addition hero, but not somebody she would chase after. D doesn't have her, but he have chased. So yeah, Ariel, I think, is one of the ones that we've seen at the very beginning. If you've been a seasoned player, you've definitely seen her on the roster for many times. The healing does a lot. So what she did normally was she had the divine protection, and she recovers the health and gives all the allies 24% mana generation, which you all know that it's killer, because of the fact is, if she's giving them all health and then she's going to fire up that 24%, that means they're going to be able to launch their special skills against you really quick. So let's take a look here and talk about what her skills are, what she does. And let me go ahead and put this on here now. Okay, so there we go. We have the Deep Sea Ritual is the special. She is of a sorcerer class, and then she's part of the Atlantis. So this is the thing, because she's a costume hero, you're gonna get a couple bonuses here. One, she's part of the Atlantis family, where you're gonna get bonuses for having multiple heroes on the same team with you during the gameplay. So you can get up to 5 heroes. And what she's going to give you for the Atlantis family, they do the special of defense. So you're going to get anywhere from 5% all the way up to 20%, depending on how many players of the same family you have together. The next thing is the costume bonus. So just by having her costume leveled up, doesn't matter which hero, if you decide to use the regular hero or this one, by leveling both the regular and the costume, you're going to get an additional 3% attack bonus, 3% on the defense. Health bonus is 6% and mana bonus 1%. So even if you don't want to use the costume version of them, if you level your hero up, you're going to get this additional bonus. So that's definitely something you want to do. So at a max level, she is a 5-star legendary hero, and she is of the ice element, which is the blue element, if you're not really sure. So the blue is the ice. And at an 80 max level, you can expect to see 765 for your attack skills, 780 on defense, and 1325 on her health. So what I'm looking right now, she's pretty good as far as defense goes. So on this type of hero here, you're not expecting any type of attack from it, so you want to go, my opinion, I would go strongly on defense or health, because what she does, she actually boosts the health of you. So if I were to emblem this hero, I would make sure that I put most of my emblems. So again, you're embleming this hero here, because you're putting the emblems on the main character, not on the costume. But the route that I would go would be defense, I mean health heavy, because the fact is, if you're gonna use her for the costume, you want her health to go higher, because she does this special skill where it exceeds the amount you have. So if you have 1325, it's gonna go higher. But if you can get 1350, 1370, or even 1400, that's when you're gonna be able to add more on top of that when you exceed the maximum health point. So let's take a look for her special skills. It's called the Deep Sea Ritual, and it's at a mana speed of average. And she boosts health of all allies by 520. So if a health exceeds the maximum health point, it is added as a temporary health point. So that's what I was saying. If she has 1325 and then she fires her special skills, now it's gonna add an additional 520 on top of that. So that would make it 1825, which is a whole lot of health there. So again, the route that I go with defense and health, let's see, if I don't know, we have some people online right now, so I'm just curious of what they think about it. So if you were to do that, which route would you go with? Would you do the health and defense, like I said? So I'm just waiting to see what you say. Now I gotta also remember, this is, we have a little delay here because we're live. It's about 10 second delay, so I just asked that question. We'll give them a few minutes to answer here. All right, let's take a look here. All right, the next thing we're gonna say is, she does all allies regenerate a moderate amount of mana over 4 turns. So the last one they did 24%. This one they're going to generate a moderate amount, which is still good because you're going to get this health and you get the moderate on top of that. And then she cleanses status elements from all allies. So I think this is a really good hero. You know, again, this is somebody that I don't know if you want to chase her, but the fact is, if you don't have the original Ariel, that'd be somebody you want to get anyway. So I would love to have Ariel on my roster. And if you get the costume as part of the bonus, it's definitely something you want. So that's what I would have. But there you go. That's my thought process on Ariel. If you like her, it's definitely somebody you should, you know, chase after. Because again, having these heroes that do these boosts make a big difference. So hopefully you enjoyed that, and I will see you on the next video.